get the camera. See, first thing I want to tell you is already I told you means how to use the camera. How we can use that camera already we have seen. So we will directly start with an example. Okay. So and also I will give you one assignment in cameras and everybody has to show me. Okay. Is it clear? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So see here, I have taken a composition. Now what I will do is, so let me import a file. So I'm going to take this bricks background, okay? And let me drag it onto this composition, okay? And then S. What is S? Scale. So you can increase the scale, okay? Okay. So now what is the thing? The thing we are going to do is, I am going to also activate the lights. Okay, we have already seen camera lights last class. This class we are going to work also with lights. Okay, is it clear all of you? Lights. So where are lights? So lights are exactly lights will be available the moment you select the 3D option. Okay, see here we have light and camera. Okay, so what do you have to do to select the 3D option? So see here, click on this toggle switches. Okay, once you click on the toggle switches, you can select this 3D option. See, so only if you select this 3D option, you can have access to light and camera. Is it clear all of you? Is it clear all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So now the thing is, see, let us not work in full mode, full resolution, because it will sometime it may slow down. So what you'll do, you'll keep it half. Okay, it's always better to work in half resolution, because it will be our work will be little bit fast. Okay, it will render fast. If not, it will be very slow. Okay, if you unless you are computer, see, this is a high configuration system. 24 GB RAM and 5 GB graphic card. But even in this system, it takes time to render. Okay, so that is why I recommend you to keep the half resolution and start working. Okay, is it clear? Okay, see here, just create a we will just type one text here. So we'll say what you'll do is, okay, see, I will directly start with the this movie title. Okay, how movie titles are going to appear? So see, Allu Arvind. Okay, we'll say Allu Arvind, or we'll say, I think the text is, we'll reduce the size. So here the text should be, we'll put Arial, okay, or we'll put impact will be nice. Okay, so is it clear all of you? Okay, so keep the center point at the center of the text. So I think all of you know how to keep the center point, right? Yes or no? Changing the center point of the text.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll say Allu Arvind presents. Okay, so you just select this and then here so where are the options actually? Okay, so we'll center align this. Okay, your paragraph is there. will center align. Okay, and then for the text we'll give red color, or we'll give better, we'll give gradient. Okay, tell me how to give gradient. Anybody can tell? Anybody can tell how to give gradient?
Gradient overlay.
Okay, layer styles, gradient overlay. Okay. Okay, then here we will use a red and yellow. Okay, we'll give red and yellow. Okay. Can change the angle also. Okay, let me, okay, right. So now we have selected the text. Okay, so and then we will keep it exactly at the middle. Okay, is it clear? So now we will turn on the 3D option for the text also. Okay, so how to turn on the 3D option for the text? See, here we have an option. Okay, just click on this box. See, only if you select the 3D option, you will be able to apply, you will be able to put the cameras. Are you all getting my point? Okay, so now what is the next step? Okay, next step is, see, I am going to apply some lighting also. Okay, so how we can apply lighting? So right click, new, and then see here we have a light. Okay, see, even lighting also you can only apply if the 3D option is on. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, see here, yes, spotlight, I have taken the spotlight. So we can also check other lights, but right now we will keep the spotlight because I am directly going to show you an example. Okay, see, can you all see? See,
sir,
lighting. So you can actually move this. See here. So you can move this light, so whichever way you like. Okay. Is it clear? And see, you can increase, you can use a double click on U. What will happen if double click on U? This will open. Okay, the list will open. Okay, and then you can give coloring to the light. So if you want more intensity to the light, what you can do? You can increase the intensity here. Are you all getting my point? You can increase the intensity. Getting my point, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay, see, you can increase the intensity so that the power of the light will increase. And also color, if you want a different color for the lighting, see here you can just give it a different lighting. See, now we have a some bluish color. If you want some different color, see, you can give. So here also, if you want some yellowish color, see, I can give some yellowish color. See, is it clear, all of you? Is it clear, all of you? Okay, so now I have given the lighting color to the light, and also I have typed the text, as well as I have taken a background. This is a bricks background. So now I am going to get the camera. Is it clear, all of you? Now I am going to get the camera, right? So how to get the camera? Tell me how to apply the camera. Anybody can tell? Nobody can tell? Right click, new, and camera. Okay, is it clear, all of you? So we'll just take one more camera. Okay, and just click OK. Is everybody listening?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, I have selected the camera. Okay. Now we will take. See here. Observe this area. Here I am going to take two views. Okay. Two views. One is a active camera. Okay. This is a active camera view. Means we can see means how the camera is changing. The output of the camera you can see in this active camera, and the controlling of the camera you can do it in this view. Okay, are you all getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now we'll do some controlling, but what I will do is I am going to get the text. See, I will select the text layer and I will just move the text a little bit. Okay, see, text is now a little bit in front. Okay, is it clear all of you? Text is little bit front, and where is the background? So this is the background. Okay, see, this is a background is little bit behind, text is over here. Okay, and what is this? Anybody can tell what is this? What is this actually?
Spotlight.
Okay, understand that. Okay, see, if I move it close, it looks like this. Move it close to the background. Okay. So now what you'll do is, see, to animate this, see, now we will first, we are going to animate what? Camera. We are going to animate camera, and see how much is the size of our composition. It is 5 seconds, right? So it's a 5 seconds, so we'll create a 3 seconds animation. Okay, so we can get 3 seconds animation. See, you just open the values here. See here. See, you can actually change some of the values. See, these are all the camera values. Are you all getting my point?
Yes, sir.
See, these are all the camera values. Here, what is this? Focal length. See, so we can change some of the values here. Okay, focal distance. See, this is zoom. See, just see the zoom. When I'm zooming, so you can see the change. Can you see the change? Can you see the change?
Yes,
sir.
Okay, see, zoom. You can keep the zoom level to exactly to the background. Okay, and then what else we are having? So here we have this focal distance. Okay, but the most interesting things here, see, if you open this transform, see, you can see the orientation here. See, can you all see the orientation? See, these three values are there. See, I can orient this. So we'll see, I can orient this like this. See here, able to understand everyone? And I can also do the y rotation here. See, able to understand everyone? And we can also turn on this depth of field, and I think say we have to reduce these values. See here, I am changing the focal distance. Are you all getting my point? And then let us see how it looks. See here. Okay. And then okay. So then we will try to just move it a little bit. Okay, so I have just moved it like this. See here, can you all see the change?
Yes, sir.
See here, we'll just keep it here. And where is our text? Hello Arjun, we'll make it, we'll scale it a little bit, okay? And we will also move it a little bit in the 3D space, okay? See ya. Okay? See. Okay? So now we'll try to animate the camera. So how we can animate the camera? So we can animate the rotation of the camera. Okay? Let us try this Y rotation, okay? Let's go to the 2 second mark. Okay, I will actually animate all the values. Okay, instead of only this Y rotation, I will animate all the values, okay? So we'll actually remove the keys. So let us animate position, orientation, rotation, okay? So let us animate all the values, okay? Is it clear all of you? So let me come here and let us try, let us see how, if you want animate the this one, and let's keep it here, okay? So let us see how it looks. See, can you see this? Can you see the change?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See this, it's coming here like this, and then we'll bring it back little bit, okay? Something like this. Okay, now we'll see. See. And also we will do one thing. We'll actually keep it a little bit close here, okay? A little bit close. Okay, then we will see. Okay, and also this should not be this much far away. We'll keep it a little bit like this. Okay, now we'll see. So 1 minute, 1 minute. And then Y rotation. Okay. Then make it behind like this. Okay. Right. See. And let us make it slow a little bit. Okay, so we can make it slow. Just select these keyframes, keep it where, keep it 5 seconds. Okay, so now let us see. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So like this. And we'll do one more interesting thing, that is, see the lighting, actually lighting is a little bit intensity is we'll increase the intensity, but at the same time this cone angle we will reduce, okay? Something like this, okay? So something like this. And also one more thing, the text also, see, for text I think here we have also option to see here shadow option is there. Can you all see the option shadows? Everybody can see this option shadows? okay, but actually the shadows are not falling, but see, it will, shadows will also fall actually, okay, because of the distance it is not falling, but you can also see the shadows, you can also get the shadows, okay. I will show you, okay, don't worry. Okay, like this. Okay. And the text. So where is the text? So here the text is there. See here the text is there now. For the text also we have this option. Okay. See, for the text also we have the option cast shadows on. Okay. But there are shadows actually. So there are shadows have there, but they are not appearing properly. Okay. See, for the bricks also we will apply the shadows. Are you all getting my point? See ya. So sometimes it takes lot of load, okay, that's why it does not come. So generally what happens is, okay, so generally what happens is the shadow of the text falls on the wall, okay. Okay, so this is the thing. Okay, we'll do one thing. I'm going to render this, okay. I will render this, and then what I will do is one text is coming from left to right, okay. Are you able to understand? Okay, left side to right side it is moving, the camera. The camera is moving from left to right. So the next one, it should move from right to left. Are you getting my point? Huh? Are you getting my point?
Okay.
Jitin, are you able to understand? Jitin?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, so how you can do that? See, first I am going to render this. Okay. So let me render. So how to render? Tell me. Just we'll go to, okay, we'll just click on this auto render queue, okay. Then I will I will take which one. I will take PNG sequence, okay. We'll take PNG sequence, and most important thing is RGB plus alpha, okay. See, this is alpha is very important, because we want to get some transparency. And then I will go here, I will go to which drive. We'll go to the G drive, and then here I am going to create one. I think we will go to, okay, E drive, because there is a lot of space in E drive. Okay, so then here I will say movie title. Okay, we will type movie title. Then we will just open this, and they will say movie. We will just type Allu Arvind presents. Okay, and then here PNG I am taking. So save, and then what is the next step? Just click on this. Render. Is it clear, all of you? It's taking time. See, all of you, how much space is there in your C drive? I want to ask this question. How much
space? 500 GB.
See, okay, even if you have 500 GB in C drive, you have 500 GB only in C
yes,
drive.
Sir.
Sir, I only have 1 TB SSD.
See, because my problem is in my system, my C drive is having less space. Actually, I have to format my system, especially for After Effects. At least keep minimum of 200 GB space for in C drive. Are you all getting my point? Tejaswini, you also, I'm telling. C drive should have at least 200 GB space. Okay?
Sir, which CPU do you use?
Processor, you are saying?
Yes, sir.
i7 processor. And if you see, if you want to know my configuration, see, I'll just type here. DX. So it will open. Wait. See here. This is my system configuration. You can see the 24 GB. Can you see this? Huh?
Yes,
24
sir.
GB RAM. And if
so
you
see, which generation is the
i7? i7, yeah.
I know, sir.
Okay.
Generation.
i7 something. I just purchased it 3 months back.
Oh, okay, sir.
Even the generation is there somewhere here. See, i7 here it is there. See, i7 ninth generation or what? What is this?
Let me look it up. I don't know actually. It's 3 GHz, right?
Yes. Okay, I think okay. And then okay, see the graphic card is. This one, okay, right. Okay, so now see, we have completed this animation. Okay, this one. So now let us say if you want to do the animation for the other text. Okay. Okay. Just a minute. Just 1 minute. Hello. 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 Yes. Athway close this session. అదే క్లోజ్ చేసేసామండి మేము. ఓకే రైట్. సో నౌ సీ హియర్, లెట్ us ట్రై టు రివర్స్ ద కీ ఫ్రేమ్స్. ఓకే, సో వాట్ విల్ హ్యాపెన్ ఇఫ్ యూ రివర్స్ ద కీ ఫ్రేమ్స్? ఎనీబడి కెన్ టెల్? సో ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు సెలెక్ట్ ద కీ ఫ్రేమ్స్, రైట్ లెగ్ keyframe assistant, here time reverse keyframes. So what will happen?
It will reverse play.
It will play in the reverse, huh?
Yes, sir.
But it is not playing, right? It's playing in the same direction or what?
No, sir, before it was zooming out, right?
No, actually the rotation I want.
Oh, okay.
So it is I think it is
we have to select the rotation frames.
Yeah, that's what I'm telling. That's what I'm also thinking. Okay. So this is what I want actually. But actually it's not coming that much interesting, okay? When I'm saying this, because I think I also have to change the orientation, I guess. The orientation also I have to change. But orientation I can't change because orientation is not animated. Okay? Okay, then I will now change the orientation. Let us see how it looks. Okay, so it's coming a little bit differently. Because it is not rotated completely here, okay? So it should look something like this. Okay, it should look completely rotated like this. Okay. Okay, wait a minute. Let me go back. Okay. Okay. So previously, it was coming in a differently, right? This direction, right? Left direction, right? Okay. Are you all getting my point? So let me actually change this to another one. Okay. So what is that another one? So let us say this is a movie. Called some action movie. Okay, so what movie will put? Something like a Gajini. Okay, we'll put Gajini. Okay, and then I will change the position actually. Okay. Are you all getting my point?
Yes,
see, I'm not changing the camera animation, okay? I'm only changing the text so that we can get both the things. See. Okay? Something like this. So we'll see how it looks actually. Let us do something. Okay, then we will, what we'll do now is, I will render again. This time I will render this one. Again, I will use this. And then what I will do? PNG sequence. Okay, we'll use the RGB plus alpha. Okay. And then we will we'll just go to the movie title and I will create one more folder here. We'll say Gajini. Okay, right? Okay, is it clear? Prashant and Bharat, are you able to understand?
Yes.
See, next class, your assignment is you have to show me a movie title. Okay? Using cameras and lights. And what is that movie title? You can decide by yourself. Okay? Okay? So now we will see, we will create one more composition here. Okay, and then we'll get the our files. Okay, so where did we save? Here. So we can get this. So we can get it in our, and we can put it in our composition, right? Okay, and then see total is 10 seconds, right? Total 10 seconds composition we have to take. So how to increase that composition size? New and right click composition settings and we'll put 20 seconds, okay? This is the 20 second composition. Able to understand everybody?
Sir.
Okay, then here after this, what you have to do? What you have to get? Tell me. We have to get the next one, which is Gajini. Okay. And this one. Okay. Then we'll get it here. Okay. And then this should be, this should start from where? At this point, okay. Able to understand everyone? How to, okay, tell me now question. How to put this, how to start, make this start from this time indicator? Tell me.
Left square bracket.
Good. So let us see now. Okay, I think see, you can do one thing actually. We could have actually done one thing, that is we could have done reverse animation, okay? Okay, I'm giving you one challenge here. Okay, the challenge is you have to do a title animation. How? See, this Allu Arvind presents will come from, come in this way, and this Gajani should come from, this is coming from what? This is coming from left to right. Okay, and this should come from right to left. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
So something like this, okay? And then what else we can do? So so after this, okay? So after this again we'll hit N and then we will just trim comp to work area. Okay, and let us say if you want to add some nice music to this. See, actually one thing I want to tell you here, see, to add a music we can actually add them in where? In Premiere actually. See, everybody, how many of you have completed your Premiere? Anybody knows Premiere? Nobody knows.
Complicated.
Okay, so you can actually add a music in the Premiere, but in case you want to add it in the directly in After Effects only, so what you have to do is, let's go to the YouTube. Okay, so we'll just type action movie music. Okay, action movie music, and then we'll just take under for duration. Okay, let's see which one is nice. So, okay, this is nice, huh? Okay, we'll use this. So how to download this? Just simply remove the UB here. Okay, and we want only the music. So we can download music. See, select the MP3 and click on this. Is it clear, all of you? Are you able to understand? Okay. See, I want you to do a action movie using camera, okay? Action movie title using camera, okay? And then how to add the music? Right leg import file, okay? And we will add the music, okay? Where is the music? Downloads. So just open the music and we'll keep it here, okay? And then let us play. Actually, if you want to get the right part, okay, means the we'll actually we can move it like this, okay. Just we can move this layer and we can select some interesting part here. Is it clear, all of you? Are you able to hear the music?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, now we will render this in MOV format, okay? Let us see how we are going to get it after we render it in MOV format, okay? Let us see. So, again we will use this render queue. And this time I am going to select which one? QuickTime. QuickTime means what? MOV, okay? And then we will select it and okay, we'll keep it in this one only, okay? We'll say Gajini movie. Okay? Bharat, are you able to understand? Bharat? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So just click render. Let us see whether we are going to get the audio also, okay? Okay? Let me check. Where is it? E drive. Okay, this one. And I am going to open it in VLC player. Okay, so this is the file we are checking. I think it's a little bit, how much a file is it? 465 MB file. We got this much file actually. See, if you want smaller files, the idea I will give you is, see, try to render this as a PNG sequence. Are you all getting my point? If you want a smaller file, see, try to render it in PNG sequence. And then what you have to do? Render it in Premiere. Getting my point, everybody?
Yes, yes.
Render that files in Premiere, because in Premiere we are going to have the MP4 format. Getting my point? Because see, it is a little bit stucking. See, if you check this file, it is not smooth. The animation is not playing smooth. Getting my point, everyone? Animation is not a little bit smooth, okay? Why? Because it is a very large file. See, we got a very big file. And why did we get a very big file? Let us see. Okay. Let us see why did we get a very big file. See here, and you select the QuickTime. So you can go to the format options. So you can select see, you can select the codec actually. See here, there are some different sizes here. Paul and different sizes are there. Okay. Sometimes because of these things, and also this file is having a audio also. Okay. So audio, because of audio also, it is very we are getting a very large file. Okay. So the solution for us is, if you want to get a smaller size file, the best solution is render these files in a PNG sequence, open it in Premiere, and then in Premiere you render. Okay, Premiere you render as MP4. And if you don't know how to render in Premiere, I think you have whoever has completed Premiere, you can ask them. Okay, Tejaswini, you know how to render in Premiere? Tejaswini, are you there? What happened? Everybody is silent. Tejaswini, Nitin.
Sir, actually I am laptop prepare lo unna sir, Premiere work em cheyaledu.
Okay. So Bharat, you know Premiere? Bharat.
Sir, not at all. So many classes, sir.
So nobody knows Premiere. Okay, nobody can, means how to render in Premiere, nobody knows. Okay.
He tried. I used Sony Vegas Pro long time ago.
Okay. See, what I am telling you is, you have to render in as a sequence in After Effects. Don't try to give final output in After Effects. Okay?
Yes, sir.
We will not use After Effects for final output. We will render these files and then we will open it in Premiere and we will give the final output of these files in Premiere. Okay? And not in After Effects. Okay. I will show you the technique so that you can see. I think some of you are having Premiere, right? Some of you, I think Nitin.
Sir, how much file size is this animation?
This is 465.
Sir, what if we render it in DVC Pro 30? I think it works better.
But one thing, yeah, if you want to see the check the output in VLC player, some formats don't open in VLC player. Even in VLC player, some formats don't open. So then what is the use then?
The rotoscopy video that I rendered, I rendered it in DVC Pro 30.
Mm-hmm.
Because otherwise the quality was getting lower in PAL format.
Mm-hmm. So you mean to say, okay,
DVC is good actually, 30 frames.
So it is opening in VLC player?
Yes, sir.
No issues.
Okay, where is it? This one you are saying?
No, sir. QuickTime and format options.
Here you are saying.
Yes, sir. DVC Pro HD 1080 30 or 25. Anything.
This one you are saying?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let us see whether we are going to get a smaller size. We'll use two, okay. Then we'll just render it again. It's taking time.
Maybe the size will be big. I don't know.
because for me that because the rotoscopy video only got like 120 MB size.
It's taking a lot of time here.
Yes, sir.
I think
maybe because of the 3D element and camera also, maybe the size will get big.
There is no 3D element here. This is, we are rendering the PNG sequence here.
We are not rendering
the 3D.
Yes, sir.
That is something you should understand. It will take a lot of memory.
Yes, sir.
See, I will tell you the suggestion. Okay, let us stop all these things. Okay. I think the system got hanged. See, it got hanged. Wait a minute.
So I guess your cache files and all is too much filled.
See, actually,
because your system is powerful enough, like very powerful.
See, the problem is my C drive is having less space. That is the problem. Even though my system has good resolution, I have to format my system and increase the space in my C drive.
Yes, sir.
That is the only thing. Okay. See, I want to tell you one technique here. All of you, this technique will be useful for you even in the future. Even for those who don't know Premiere also, please listen to me, okay? Because you are all in this C++ field, you should know this, okay? And I will add music also in where? In Premiere, see here. We will render the complete sequence in a this one PNG sequence, okay? So where is the PNG sequence? Okay, and then we will go to the movie title. So just we'll create on folder here, okay? Complete movie, okay? And then we will say again we will say Rajni title, okay? Is it clear, all of you? And then what will do? Render. Okay, did we render? Oh, it's taking one more time here. Wait a minute. Did you render it in PNG? 1 minute. I think I have not set the on option here. See, I have not set this option. RGB plus alpha, okay? I forgot to set that option. And we'll just say complete movie. Rajini title final, we'll say, okay? And then now we'll start rendering. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
See, the file size is actually the file size is very important for all of you. Don't think that if you get a large file, it's some great achievement. Okay, you always have to make sure that file size is consistent. Okay, now see, I'm opening Premiere. Okay, see, I have opened the Premiere. We'll just say testing. Okay, everybody can see my screen, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, see here, actually we will import it. So where is our file? E drive. Where is movie title? And complete movie. And what is that? What is the name we have given?
Final.
Final, right? Gajini title final, right? Where is it? Yeah. This one. This one only.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes,
I think this one. Okay, this one. Okay, image sequence. Click on the image sequence. Okay. And then I will just drag it here. So how this works? I think see, I think your source have already told you. I think right. So this is the Premiere software, and we will add a sound here, audio here. See here, where is our audio? I think we have just now downloaded the audio, right? So this is the audio. See here, and I will. Okay, so I will just extract the audio here. We'll keep it till here. Okay. So we'll just trim it here. Okay. Okay. See now, just you see here. I think we did not get the full title or what? Where is it? We did not get the full title here. Okay. Okay. So we can actually extend this. This is all over and presents, and then here, from here we are going to get what? This one we are going to get. Okay, so here it is there now. See, I will now render this and in Premiere and show you. Okay, so we'll just say. So here, see the thing here. Everybody can see this.
Yes, sir.
There is extension is what? MP4. Okay, you can just we'll just put it in E drive. We'll keep it in movie title and then we'll say. Final output, okay. Final output, oh, Gajini title. Okay, so just we'll save this and then I will render it, export it for one last time. See how much fast it is taking. Can you see the speed?
Yes,
see, now you'll see the see this. Where is that our file? Final output. See, this is the actual file. See. It is now, it is the actual file. This file you can put it even in the YouTube. Is it clear? And we also got a nice music, and see the difference here. Just to see the difference. See the difference. How much is it? 83 MB we got, or we, this one is how much we got? 465 MB. And how much is this? 8 MB.
Yes, sir.
See,
it's compressed format.
No, it's not compressed. It is good.
No, sir. MP4 is actually a good compression technique for video.
Means it did not lose its quality.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Even quality is nice. Okay, so that is the advantage of MP4, and to get MP4 we have to create a sequence.